was married 45 years. Wow. And something must have worked for him. So this is his advice. Keep your eyes wide open before marriage and half shut afterwards. Those that are married know what that's all about.
That's great.
I got the book.
Thank you. That's true. Anybody else have a good idea?
I'll go with Molly. And this comes from me with a little help. I looked up some stuff, but also married 45 years.
All
so,
right.
Yeah.
Same 45 years.
Yeah.
So they say.
Yeah. So you have to take the good with the bad, smile when you're sad, love what you've got, remember what you have. Always forgive, but never forget. Learn from your mistakes, but never regret. People change, things go wrong, but remember, life goes on.
Yeah. Anybody else?
I can read mine. Do you
Great.
Have it in there?
Yes, I do.
Okay. You ready to go, Fred?
There you go.
Well, Frank, my husband wrote his, which is very interesting, as the attorney. He had bullet points, and at the end it was like, in conclusion. Mine is very heartfelt. And
they say the same
thing. Said the exact same thing, but in a totally, totally different way. So Frank has to read his. Okay, marriage? Yes, you have.
This is how you stay from marriage.
Yeah. Happy wife, right? Marriage is rewarding, difficult, hard work, and a commitment to each other. It's nice to come home to a partner you can rely on and build a life together. I love having a trustworthy, loving, caring partner I can lean on during the rough times. But it's really fabulous to have a partner during the fun times and adventures. I use that word quite often, though. I love adventures, something as small as a drive to the beach or as grand as a trip to Australia. Sharing a life with someone you love is the best part of every day. What did I tell you from day one was the most important thing in relationships? Communication, that's it. Communication is the most important part of a marriage or any relationship. He's getting much better because of you. You're bringing that out to him, and I love it. I've tried for 34 years. My children know I said this to them since the day they were born. Yeah, I didn't say that. I threw that in. I believe Anthony and Ibra are a good example of this. They seem to have their own unique style of communicating. Love is, of course, important, but the day you get married and commit to each other, the love is there. I don't know how to give advice on how to make love last. I do know when my husband goes away on a business trip, I still miss him. I guess that's love. We are celebrating our 40th anniversary this month. I'm not going to cry. Trust is very important. I trust Frank with my life. I knew he was the right person for me when we were dating, when I put his needs and happiness before mine. In other words, his happiness meant the world to me. For example, when we were dating, my husband's idea of adventure was going on the biggest roller coasters, hiking to the highest peak, driving very fast on the most narrow, dark roads in the rain. Yes, he did that. His little Mustang, the stick shift. This city girl from Queens, I wanted to go to the movies, Broadway shows, romantic dinners. He wanted to be outside all the times, and I associated outside with heat, bugs, and all sorts of creepy critters. I was definitely a city girl. Our first picnic, which was going off script, was in Princeton, which I live now. And he was very excited, and he put down his blanket, and I sat on a mouse. I was traumatized. I still I still am thinking about it.
Did you kill it?
No, it just ran off, and I just had met him, so I wanted to be cool. I was freaking out.
So did the mouse run off, or did you
mouse
run off?
I stayed
as
quiet
as
I did say. No, the mouse ran off, and then we wanted to sit there for one, like, I think we should go home now. Yeah. I think we're done with the picnic. So I was laughing when you said about the picnic last week. Remember when you said that?
Yeah.
Okay, where am I? Hacking events. Okay, my point is, I've heard fitness. Okay, my point is, marriage is all about compromise. We are opposite, but I went on those roller coasters, and I did. Hiking adventures, and hung on for dear life around those winding roads when he drove too fast.
And I went to the movies and the theater.
Why? Because I loved him. Seeing him happy brought me joy. Of course we went to the movies, romantic dinners, and shows. My every decision to this day, I always think about my partner and will it please him. We are always trying to keep each other happy and be sure both of us needs are met. You won't like everything about your partner. In fact, there are days when you can't even look at them. But you hang in there because of your love, respect, trust, and the life and the family you have built together. Family is everything to me. My sons are my greatest accomplishments. My last piece of advice is the person you commit to is not perfect. You have to accept those faults. I know Frank is now saying he has no faults. You get to read each other's minds. Right, Frank? I know you're saying that. Marriage and everyday life can be boring. Don't mistake that for a bad marriage. Life has its ups and downs. So does marriage. I do believe Anthony and Eva have all these traits for a solid marriage. Their deep love is evident just spending 5 minutes with them. They trust each other, really love spending time with each other, and their faces light up around each other. I think you complement one another and are truly the same in so many ways. I wish for you a life filled with love, adventures, good health and happiness. I love you both.
And I did write these separately, and the styles are very different.
Yeah, you'll have to show yours.
Yeah. Mine is, I need a clicker, and mine is much more efficient. Yeah.
They're all fine. It's like a conference room. It's like show it up and show them. It's like a bullet point. It's hysterical. It
certainly
yeah.
is.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. I have do's and don'ts, actually. Okay, Anthony and Eva. Marriage can be wonderful. Having a partner to share life with is reassuring and comforting, but it can also be challenging. Not every day will be perfect, and some will be very difficult. But that's life, whether you are married or not, and it is better to have someone there to go through it with you. Enjoy your time with one another. Try to go easy on yourself and your partner. And always remember that you are in it together, for better or worse, and never give up. At the end of the day, your marriage will be unique, and while the advice of the people, including us, that you love and respect can help, you will ultimately pave your own path and learn, as we all have, from your individual experiences and mistakes. Anyway, I tried to put down some practical guidance based on my approach, some of which I still need to work on a bit, for you to consider as you start your journey together. Be there to support your partner, always. Be reliable. Your actions should let your partner know that you are there and they can lean on you for support. Be vulnerable. You should not hesitate to lean on your partner when you need to. Take good care of yourself, as this will help you. As this will help you take care of each other. Be respectful, loyal, strong, and compassionate. Don't expect a fairy tale. Your partner is not perfect, neither are you. While you have some extraordinary experiences, most days will be routine. Have reasonable expectations of everyday life. Don't dwell on inconsequential annoyances. Take a deep breath. Be willing to compromise. Try to attack the problems, not each other. Work hard. Find the right roles for each of you, not necessarily 50-50 for every chore. Get your finances in order. Keep learning, growing, and trying new things. Discuss and pursue your dreams and aspirations together.
I'm sorry, the phone's going to keep ringing if I don't tell them. Go away.
Be persistent. Don't overindulge in excesses. Create a home, a place that you cherish and enjoy to be in together, a place that your family and friends love to visit and spend time, your own sanctuary. Create a family. Discuss kids. Discuss the in-laws and holidays. Have fun. Dress up and go out on dates. Go on adventures together. Hold hands. make love, do lots of things together, but also have some me time. Remember, you are blessed. Be appreciative. Take nothing for granted. And say thank you.
By saying, you know, you could be right. And don't expect the other person to change just because you want them to. That's not the deal. That doesn't mean you can't make your feelings clear. Use your basic I message. For example, I feel blank when blank because. I feel grateful when you bring me coffee in bed because it lets me know you are thinking about me. Or, I feel annoyed when you eat all the Oreos because then there are none left for me. And leave it at that. If the other person argues with you, hard to do with an I statement. Just repeat your message and add, I just thought you would want to know. If you come home to a sink full of dirty dishes and are mad because you already shared how you feel about that, try setting a timer for how much time, 5 minutes, 10 minutes, that you are willing to spend on dishes without complaining about it or feeling resentful. Stop when the timer goes off and let the rest go. It's better than being mad all the time about the same old thing, and you'd be surprised how much you can get done in 10 minutes. Make your main focus be on what your partner does that you are grateful for. Focusing on what's not working is a trap that's hard to get out of. Nobody's perfect. And my husband, Chris, contributed, and my little parentheses, you'd probably do fine just doing these three things. Listen, learn, and compromise. Love, love, love.
Mark and J.A., did you want to read any of yours?
I think we're going to wait and just do the music.
I would like to read mine.
Okay.
So rather than giving advice, because it just seemed like you'd be getting an awful lot of advice, and now you need all this advice, this is a poem. And you can interpret it how you want, and maybe there's something there that you can use, but it's not for me to interpret it for you. This is an Irish poem. It's very short. I love you not for the way you speak, or the way you smile, or the way your beautiful eyes stare into my soul. I love you because every time I think of you, I feel like a lost traveler who has finally found the way home. That says it all if you want to really look at it.
That's great. Goodness. Thank you. Who
Well, I would, but after you.
I'm not reading my whole thing. Let's see. Make a pact early in your relationship. Commit to a few things you agree are important of your own choosing. We agreed, I'm talking about Jeff and me, that no matter how strongly we disagreed on something or how mad we might get at each other, we would speak respectfully to each other. It's good to commit to that one early because your way of speaking to and treating each other very quickly becomes habit. And this, of course, becomes even more important when you have kids. When you take your vows, mean them. Sometimes the promise is the only thing that keeps you going during the rough patches until you come out the other side. Pardon the mixed metaphor. And then I have a few more. Let's see. Yeah, I'm going to leave these for private. And Pekka.
Well, some things, as I said, that don't do what I do, but do as I say. Learn to tell how you feel, even about the tiniest things, even when you know it will upset the other. Learn not to try to fix your or the other's feelings. Everybody has a lot of baggage that one doesn't even know about, but empathy and love may help to understand that. Not every feeling is about you, even if it arises from what you might have done or left undone. It's not easy, but it pays for the long run.
Anybody else? Martina, you want to read yours? Okay. This is Jeff.
Yeah, I'll say something in that. There. No, I can do it here. I can. No, I am. I'm just putting myself on the camera.
Okay.
Selfie style.
Yeah.
Selfie.
And it's really not very, it's not prepared at all, because I'm struggling to come up with comments for the wedding itself, and I didn't want to blow my creativity here.
Great.
But I woke up this morning, and I recommend the On Being show that was today. It was this, a mystic woman talking about marriage, and an Irish philosopher or poet talking about marriage and love. And I always find her show rewarding, but it was topical. And he gave an example of Irish. He says there's an important word that the Irish can't get, you know, without saying 10 words, and the word is trust in English. And apparently, to say that in Irish, you have a word or a series of words that means where I would like to place my sore foot when it hurts.
Aww. Aww.
I love that.
That's great.
That's great.
Anybody else before we round up?
I just have something to give them.
Okay.
I'm less chatty than my sister. I'm the quiet, shy one. So I'm just going to give them this. And it should say everything, I think. Considering I'm married 37 years and my husband's not here. So we'll just leave it at that.
This is
good.
Great. These silly folks. It's a photo of us wearing all of our ribbons from the other shower.
And just live, laugh, and laugh.
Live, laugh, and love.
Okay, Bonnie has something.
This is just like really quick. Things that I think I either did or didn't do in my previous relationships. Even when you're angry, don't call each other names. Or at least do your very best not to. Even if you disagree on something, and you still disagree, it's okay to say sorry if you hurt someone's feelings or if you made someone sad. And you can say sorry without being in agreement about something. Respect each other's time and energy. Just always. Maintain your friendships outside of your relationship, and also outside and together if you can. Think about why you love your partner often and tell them. And be kind to one another.
I'll have more to say, but some marital advice that we would like to share with you is don't jump into the ocean with your wedding ring on. because I lost my first ring on my honeymoon. So don't do that. Dolphins got it.
But at least you didn't lose your first
one. I didn't lose my first one.
Baby!
Let's go. Go right into it.
You make me feel like a natural woman. Who needs to feel so inspired?
Of my life.
Yeah. Okay.